Whether you need to backup important files or sync your data between several devices, MegaCloud is probably the best service to do it on Linux. Mega provides robust cloud storage with strong emphasis on privacy. It features user-controlled encryption, and what is the most attractive, you get 50 gig storage for free. Do you know any other cloud service with such attractive features? Let's have a look at it in more details. Hello everyone, it's Rich Linux User, helping you to install, configure and use Linux. Subscribe for more Linux videos. Everything is moving to the cloud nowadays, and it is very convenient because you can access your data from anywhere. I am a long-time Dropbox user. I use it to sync files between different computers and to backup the most important files. The problem, however, Dropbox gives you only 2 gigs for free. I am lucky on that side. Over the years, I extended my Dropbox free space to almost 25 gigs by bringing friends to Dropbox. But if you just open a Dropbox account, you are restricted to 2 gigs of free space, unless you pay to upgrade. But there is a better alternative. A few days ago, I was helping my sister to arrange a data storage solution for her, and I found MegaCloud service. I was surprised by the features it offers. You get 50 gigs of free space, very functional web interface that can be enhanced with Firefox and Chrome add-ons, native graphical and command line applications for Linux, a mobile client for Android and other mobile OSs. All data is encrypted on the user end, so the company cannot read your data. And the last, but not the least, Mega is open source software, so you can check the code and decide if you trust it or not. All the code is available on GitHub. You can test Mega web application even without registering. Just drag and drop a file to the website. Creating an account is also very easy. Enter your name, email, and a password. After you have registered on the website, it is important to backup the recovery key. You will receive an email with the link to the recovery key. Alternatively, you can go to the settings and in the tab email and password, you can find your recovery key. You can either save the file with the key or copy it to the clipboard and paste somewhere in a safe place, for example in your password manager. The Mega web application is neat. In the main tab, you have your account overview. In the next tab, you can see your cloud folders and files. Here you can preview images, you can also mark your files with different color, and you can also mark them as your favorite with a star. If someone shares Mega folders or files with you, you will see them in this tab. You can also have a contact book if you know someone who also uses Mega. There is even a possibility to chat with your contacts. You can also make audio and video calls, but I have not tested how well they work. At the bottom you have your trash bin, then settings. I'm not going to explain you all the available settings. They are very simple and clear. I will stop more on the desktop app settings. And the last tab is the transfer history. I have tested this web app by transferring several files of around 1 gig size each. It worked quite well. All the transfers were successful. Mega recommends installing web browser Mega add-ons for better performance and security. If you intend to use only the web interface, install the add-ons for your browser. It is a very simple add-on, you just need to install it and enable it. However, I believe most of the users will use Mega desktop application. To download the desktop program, you need to go to the main menu and in the app section, find Sync Client. It is available for all popular distributions. I will download and install a Linux Mint version. I have also tested Mega on Arch Linux. It is available in the AUR. In Linux Mint, the installation process is very simple. You need to right-click on the deb file and select Open with GDebi Installer. Then click Install, enter your password, and when the installation is complete, close the installer. But it is always better to install packages from a command line, so you can better see if any errors occurred during the process. Open the terminal and type sudo dpkg with option I and the path to the file. This command should work on Debian and any Debian distro, like Ubuntu, Linux Mint, Elementary OS. When the program is installed, you can find it in your menu by typing Mega Sync. It opens in your system tray. Click on the icon and you will see the summary of the program. To see more details on upload download, you need to click on this icon with arrows. Here you see any active processes, download and upload history, and the list of complete tasks. You can also pause the sync process from this window. Alternatively, you can go to the main window and click on the pause button. If you click on the settings icon, you can add files to the upload queue or download the files from the cloud. You can even stream files directly from the Mega Cloud. I tried to stream a video file. It worked fine when I streamed it to Firefox. But VLC was not able to stream it. I don't know why. Maybe it is because of the encryption. In the settings, you can see the details on how much free space you have. You can backup your recovery key if you still have not done it or lost it. Here you can also enable the desktop notifications and auto start of the program. If you use Mega only to backup your files to the cloud, you can disable the auto start and open Mega only when you need to backup something. You can also switch to your native language here. In the sync tab, you can choose which folders you want to sync. In the bandwidth tab, you can limit the upload and download speed. If your transfers do not start, you can also try to disable HTTP as recommended here. If you use proxy, you can configure it here. In the last, advanced tab, you can configure Mega on the cloud side. You can choose where you want to upload your files. This is very convenient, because you can sync only specific folders from the cloud. So I have the folder Mega Sync as my sync folder between devices, whereas other folders serve as a backup. This is much better than Dropbox, which syncs everything what is in the cloud. And you have an option to exclude some files from syncing if you want. For example, it doesn't sync any hidden files that start with a dot. If you need to sync your hidden files, remove this filter. These were the settings. You also have a direct option to add a folder to the sync from the main interface. Here you can also open existing folders that are synchronized. Now let's have a look at the mobile app, and in the end, I will show you the command line Mega client. I tested the app on Android. The mobile app is mostly similar to the web interface. Obviously, you have all your cloud folders and files. Then there is an option to save for offline, but I wasn't able to figure out how it works. When you click on a file, there is only an option to download, which just technically makes the file available offline, but it appears in the device folders, not in the offline section of the Mega app. Anyway, it's not a big deal. A useful option is camera uploads. You can enable it to backup all your photos from a phone. The rest of the options are the same as in the web app. The only drawback, there is no chat option in the mobile client. The settings are pretty simple. Good to see that you can enable a pin code lock to have an extra security layer. The mobile app is good and does the job, but it is not an ultimate pack. Maybe they will add the chat option later and fix the offline option. Let's see. Now, the command line interface. The command line program can be useful if you want to use Mega on a server, where you cannot run graphical apps. To have a command line interface, you need to download and install Mega CMD program. To start the program, run in your terminal, mega-cmd. It welcomes you with this message. It says that it is a beta program and something may not work correctly. You can type help and see all the available commands. I believe many of these commands are the same as in the standard FTP. You can list the files with ls, change directories with cd, download a file with get, upload with put. There are many other options. I believe if you run a server, you will be able to figure out how to use it. Well, this is what I wanted to share with you. Mega seems to be a very good cloud service for a Linux user. I recommended it to my sister and I started to use it myself. I also would like to state here that it is not sponsored by Mega, in case you thought about that. Let me know what you think about Mega, and if you know any better cloud solution, please share it in the comments. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe if you want to see more videos like this.